behind the headlines of the paper, there's a space entitled Personal. And because I'm young and sensitive, that's the place I turn to first of all. 'Cause in between the viral massage, sauna baths, the rubber goods, the corsetries, someone sends a message that is classified as advertising. Agony. Agony will always find a way. You read their everyday true life love stories, taken short. Agony at 7 and a kick of time. A stifled sob per line, a list of breaking hearts and surgical supports. Molly, won't you please come home? I miss you. Won't you please forgive me? I love you very much and I am sorry for what I did. Love, Sydney. Artistic photographs, plain paper covers, 59 and sixpence postage free. Unsightly hair on arms and legs and faces is removed quite painlessly. Who knows if wayward Molly will return? Does Sydney really yearn? And if he does, does Molly care? What quarrel set them at each other's throats? Did Sydney send for postcards through the post? Or did Molly grow superfluous hair everywhere? Widow 46 would like sophisticated gentlemen to contact her. Similar interests and with a view to friendliness. Motor car preferred. Mrs. Ivy Armitage thanks all her friends for kindnesses when times were hard. And the Honourable Dickie Chalmers is not sending anybody any Christmas cards. Dynamic methods strengthen and refine the power of your minds in case your memories are none too good. And if you cannot manage on your own, take out a personal loan, there's no security. It's understood. 7 days free trial for an anti-nuclear shelter. No obligations at all. And there's news of debutantes coming out with all the customary Belgrade balls. 10 shillings reward, box number 33 has gone and lost her butchery girl. Happy birthday, darling Sheila, from your mummy and your daddy, wherever you are. But right behind the headlines of the paper, there's a space entitled Personal. And if you get the agony, that's the place to turn to.